नमस्ते बच्चों, आई एम मोहित गुप्ता एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई होप एंड विश दैट एवरीबॉडी इज सेफ एंड साउंड एट देयर होम्स एंड आर ऑल्सो फॉलोइंग द गाइडलाइंस एंड द एडवाइजरीज इशूड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एंड द लोकल अथॉरिटीज. एट दिस पॉइंट इन टाइम इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू स्टे सेफ एंड टू अबाइड बाय ऑल द गाइडलाइंस एंड precautions issued by the local authorities. Now, children, today we will be starting with the literature part of grade 9th. And as you can see on the screen, the first topic that we have chosen is a poem. The title of the poem is The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost. Before I move into the details of this poem, I would like to tell you something about Mr. Robert Frost. His full name was Robert Lee Frost. He was born in San Francisco, California, United States of America. He's an American poet. However, his most of the work was published in Britain before America. And he's a poet who is very close to nature. You'll find a lot of nature in his poetry. And this poem, The Road Not Taken, is not an exception. As you can see, that this poem is actually divided into 4 paragraphs. I'll just move the screen a little bit and I'll let you see the remaining 2 paragraphs as well. This is the 3rd paragraph and this is the 4th paragraph. So in totality, we have 4 paragraphs in this poem. And before I move to line by line explanation of the poem, I just want to discuss the brief summary of the poem so that you have a fair understanding as to what we are going to study today. Now, in this poem, Mr. Frost, who happens to be the main character, was traveling one day, and while he was traveling, he was in the middle of a wood. Wood here stands for forest. And he was traveling on a straight road in the midst of a forest. And after some time, he reached a point where the road forked into two. Okay. On the right hand side of the screen, you can see that there is a pictorial representation of what I just said. Here, this is the road Mr. Frost was walking on. And once he reached this point, okay, then the whole story starts from here. When he reached this point, the road forked into two, as you can see in the pictorial representation, that there are, the main road has ended here, and then two sub-roads have come out of that main road. Now, he was standing here, and he was in a confused state of mind. Okay, the confusion started to creep up. What kind of confusion? The confusion was about the fact that where to go, which one to choose, the right hand side or the left hand side. So he stood there for a while, pondered about what needs to be done, and then he looked as far as he could on both the roads, and he found that both the roads went straight and then they bent into the overgrowth or the undergrowth. What does undergrowth mean? Undergrowth means the forest. Okay, both of them went into different directions of forest, and after a certain point viewing, both of them were had disappeared in the forest. Basically, the human eye has a certain radius which it covers. You know, after that, everything seems to be together. So same is the case with these roads. He could see as far as the roads bent into the undergrowth. Then again, he examined the roads once again to make a choice. Now he was standing on that juncture where he had to make a choice no matter what. Okay, in order to move forward, he has to make a choice. So after spending a lot of time in contemplating as to what needs to be done, he finally chose a road which he would take to carry forward his journey. And the road that he chose was grassy and it appeared to be not used much in comparison to the road which he did not choose. So basically, he made altogether a different kind of a decision. You know, most of us, if we get stuck in such a situation, after examining both the roads, we would most probably choose the road which appears to us as if it is traveled by more people. But on the contrary, Mr. Frost chose the road which was less traveled by people. So, and then he also says, it was morning time, and in the morning, both the roads were looking very fresh because not much travelers had traveled as yet, because it was morning. The leaves were the leaves which had fallen overnight from the trees late on both the roads, and since he was alone, he wanted to travel on both the roads and see which roads leads to what kind of a destination. But it was not to be, because he was, as I told you, at such a juncture wherein he had to opt for one and had to forgo the other. Because as a single person, it is not possible for us to travel on two roads at the same time. So same was the situation with Mr. Frost. So finally, he made a decision and he chose the road which was less traveled by. So basically, by these examples, or by this poetry, Mr. Frost wants us to understand the fact that every person, one day or the other, falls in such a situation wherein he or she has to make some kind of decision. And that decision can be a maker or a breaker. You know, at times we come across certain scenarios wherein very important decisions needs to be taken. Yes, everybody trusts their instincts. Everybody tries their best to make the best decision which would favor them in the coming future. But once the decision is made, you know, once we choose to do something, there is no turning back. You know, life don't give you freebies. Life don't give you extra chances. Once life has given you a chance to make a decision, and once you make that decision, that's it. That's the end of it. You cannot revert back and say after a couple of years, or after a decade or so, you don't have the option to go back and change what you had done in the past and rewrite your destiny. No, that's not what it is. The destiny or the script has to be written then and there when you make that decision. And then towards the end of the poem, he says that, yes, that was the decision I made that day, and I chose to walk on a road which was less traveled by. And I still remember that there were two roads which diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. Now, the last line, "and that has made all the difference," is quite a debatable line. You know, a lot of research, a lot of scholars have worked on it and tried to get what Mr. Frost is actually trying to say. Is he saying it in a negative manner, or is he saying it in a positive manner? Is he regretting his decision, or is he happy with his decision? There is ambiguity in everything. You know, we are not very sure as to what kind of a difference is Mr. Frost talking about. But yes, we can definitely say that he does not really regret what he said, what he chose that day. And I'm using the word really. There might be some other things that are going on in his mind. But at the same time, he would have loved to travel on the road which he left that day. That means which he did not choose that day. Because that was a wish which Robert Frost wished. You know, if he had got a chance to travel on that road also, he would have seen what was in store for him if he had taken that road. Saying this, I do not mean to say that he is really regretting for what he had done. That means he is not really regretting as to for the decision that he made on that particular day to travel on a road which was less traveled by. So basically, the whole idea of this poem revolves around decision making, revolves around what kind of a thought process you have, what kind of decisions you take in order to move forward in your future. And the decisions that you had made in the past, do they prove to be good or bad, is always a mystery. Because once you make the decision, you have to wait for the outcome, you know. And then when you are in a position to taste the outcome of that decision, then is when you realize whether the decision that you had made a couple of years ago regarding, you know, whatever the scenario was at that point in time, was that the right decision, or was it the wrong decision which leads to regret? So that's the basic structure or the idea of the poem, "The Road Not Taken" by Robert Frost. Now, in today's class, I'll go for the line by line explanation of first two paragraphs. The first two paragraphs I'll be discussing with you line by line. So, to start with, two roads diverged in a yellow wood. Very simple, as I told you, that there were two roads which diverged in a yellow wood. Yellow wood here stands for forest. Forest in autumn season, when the leaves are falling, the leaves are withering. Okay, that's the notification which Mr. Frost has used in order to define the forest, because it was autumn season. And in the second paragraph, he says, not paragraph but the line, he says, "and sorry I could not travel both, and be one traveler long I stood." And he immediately realizes that as he is a single person, he will not be able to travel both the roads. That's why he uses the word sorry. He says, "Sorry, I am not in a position to travel both the roads." and be one traveler. And be one traveler here means as I am a single traveler. I don't have the liberty, or it's not practically possible for me to walk on two roads. Long I stood. Why? Long I stood means because now I have to make a decision. Now I have to choose between the two roads. Which one do I follow? So what he did in order to choose? And looked down one as far as I could. As I told you in the summary, while explaining the summary, he said, and I stood there and I started to look as far as I could towards each road, to where it bent in the undergrowth. To where it bent in the undergrowth means, but what I could see was both the roads, they somehow got lost in the forest. That's all I could see. Both the roads were going deep in the forest. So there was nothing much that I could get out of what I was trying to see. Then, but you just can't keep on waiting there. So he moved forward. Then took the other just as fair. So finally, he had to make a decision. There has to be some progress. So in order to make that progress, he finally took a decision, and he says, I then finally decided to take the road which was just as fair. Just as fair means it was looking as good as the other road. That means here the poet is saying both the roads were of like the same category. So I chose one of the roads out of those two roads, and having perhaps the better claim. And having perhaps the better claim. Here the word perhaps is very important, because it was his personal thinking that this road which I chose is having a better claim. Better claim means a better opportunity, a better decision. That road sounded to him or appeared to him as the road which would lead to betterment as far as he is considered, because it was grassy and wanted wear. Why? Because according to him, that was the road which was not traveled by many people, you know. So maybe he thought that towards the end of this road there will be better opportunities, better options available, as this road was not traveled by many people. However, the other road was withered, was worn out, and it seemed that that road had been used by a lot of people. That means a lot of traveling has had already been done on that road. However, this road appeared to be a little more fresher and greener and grassier as compared to the other road. Though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. Then he says, though this was not very, much used, had warned them really about the same. But the travelers had traveled on both the roads, and there was a kind of, movement which was appearing on both the roads. But he finally decided to walk on a road which was less traveled by, because of his personal contemplation, because of his personal decision. He thought that the road which I would choose today is the road which is less traveled by, because I feel that this road has a better claim, and out of that better claim it will eventually lead to better opportunities and better things that I might just receive and would benefit me at the end of the day. So these are the two paragraphs that I have explained you today, along with the summary and some information about Robert Frost. In our next class, we will be continuing with the next two paragraphs, and I will also discuss some literary devices which are used by Mr. Frost in this poem. Till that time, just go through this video, get a hang of what this poem is about, and stay safe, stay with your family, have good time, and God bless. Thank you.